Okay, it's gonna get really good now.
All right. We got a 1985 world champion bull rider. 10 Nuce.
Along with the Bull Riding Hall of Fame inductee, Wasey Cathy, they co-hold the record in bull riding for the most qualifications at the National Finals Rodeo. Think about this, 14 times at the NFR riding bulls, and that is Ted Nuce. And he's also the only bull rider to win an Olympic gold medal, winning it in 1988 at the Calgary Olympic Games. And Ted, of course, was one of the 20 co-founders of the PBR. You got a Ted Nuce story?
Ted Nuce took me to his house. I was at a riding school. I was having a riding school in, I think, Ceres, California. I met Ted Gromley there. We were doing this riding school, and Ted took me to his house, and we were going to rope some steers. So he'd get horses saddled, and I said, "What are we going to go rope?" And he said, "Well, right here." I looked around, I mean, everything in California would be pretty kind of close together, and I'm going, "Well, where do you rope?" And I go, "Right here." He said, "There's this alley that we work cattle, you know, there's this alley, it's 8-9 foot wide." He said, "We run them down here, we rope them, and then you turn left at the end of the barn." I mean, so it's just a little, 10 foot alley. And we let one series out and roped him. Down and off, turn around and go around the end of the barn. Ted could really heal because, two more steps and I run into the manure pile, at the end of the barn where they muck them out. But, I had no idea that they rode horses. I mean, they were in town. And I'm thinking, man, this guy's not just a bull rider, he's a cowboy. Ted Nuce was one of those guys that was more of an athlete than my group of guys. We were not in horrible shape, but we were doing everything that we could to get out of shape. And, Teddy brought a youthfulness when I was still riding, thinking that I could beat somebody. His group of guys gave some more energy to a guy that was getting a little bit road weary and, having those rather rapid brown butt attacks that couldn't ride a bull. So, it was awfully fun to watch a guy that's really fired up or just somebody that can really ride getting on because he thinks he ought to. And it was a lot of difference.
Take the microphone and go to Ty and get some Ted Nuce stories from Ty. I can see your eyes light up.
I'm just sitting here, man. But yeah. Ted, Ted Nuce has been a huge inspiration to me. When I was in high school, he was at his peak, and I thought he was the best winner I'd ever seen. He could dress up bulls that, he knew how to win. He knew how to be dynamic. He loved the sport. I've known Ted now personally for 30 years, and he's told me every day that I've ever seen him for 30 years that it's going to be a great day. And he lived by that. Now I get to watch him be a dad, and he's great at that. And it's really been a pleasure having him as kind of a model that goes before me. He helped me in my riding, and it still helps me now. And we get to be together, and we don't live very far from each other. He just is really now starting to get his due going into the Hall of Fame in Oklahoma City and going into this Hall of Fame because he truly is a legend in this game.
Thank you. I'm going to go over here to Jerome Davis because I know that, Jerome, you were starting right about the time that Teddy was hanging it up, huh?
Yeah, I did. But one of the members I remember of, him and Adam and Gilbert were rodeoing together, and it's out in California. I catch rides with them guys, and we went to eat at this high-dollar steakhouse, and I didn't have much money. And they had this little game they liked to play. It's called the numbers game. Well, long story short, I ended up having to buy. You pick the number, if you pick the number, you end up having to buy. Well, it was funny how they just bounced around that number so easy. And after I left there that day, I got to thinking about it. I think I've been had on a steak dinner the first time I met Ted Nuce.
That's a good one. All right, Ted, come on up. Your turn to tell some stories.
It's a great day. We're so lucky when we can find our passion. And all of you guys in here rodeo and made a living, we found our passion at an early age. And we got to live that dream, you know, for maybe 20 years. How lucky were we? How lucky, how blessed were we to live in America and have an opportunity to wake up and do exactly what we love every single day. Bull riding, I know bull riding is dangerous, very dangerous. If you make a mistake, you know, it can be all over. But I've seen, you know, people die in car wrecks. People have all kinds of ways to die. And I always figured it, when it was my day, I didn't care what I was doing, I wasn't going to get out of it. And I know that, you know, the Lord had a purpose for me and a time for me, and my time my number hasn't come up yet. But I know that if you're doing what you love, you can't beat life. Life is great if you get to do what you love every day. And I grew up in California, and I went to Larry Mahan's bull riding school, right here in where this picture was taken, in Comanche, Lake Comanche. And I'd been on one bull before I went to that school, and I was about 14 years old. And at the end of the school, I got on this little bull, his name was Pluto, and I asked Donnie if he remembered him. He said, yeah, he's a good spinner right out there at the ride. Well, I'd only been on maybe 12 or 13 bulls, and that bull turned back, and I was just able to stay on him. He just bucked right into my hand. Everything was easy, and it was fun. And boy, was I hooked. I was really hooked. And then a little later, I went to LeFou School, and then things really began to change for me, because LeFou taught me if I really believe in myself, I could achieve anything. If I set these goals for myself and I kept working at them every single day, that things could happen. And I'm teaching my bullet to do the exact same thing today, because I know how life can be if you start setting goals for yourself and you start achieving things. It just doesn't get any better. And if you do that, you know, sometimes you end up in a place like this where all this history, all this great history was formed right here in this building, you know. How many great rides you think was taking place right here? How many great cowboys have ridden right here where we're standing? I mean, going all the way back to the beginning nearly. It's just awesome. It doesn't get any better. One time, I got a funny story, because Wasey Cathy, he's going to get inducted here in a minute, and he's going to get a chance to speak. Sorry that I get to go before you. But it's an Angels camp story. We were at Redding, California, this very time, like right now, because it's Angels camp, and Redding is going on right now. Well, let's see. Today's Saturday. Okay, this is how it played out, you guys. Saturday night, we're up at Redding, okay? And tomorrow, we're up at Angels camp. And my mom told everybody that Wasey and Charlie and myself were right at Angels camp. And all of her friends, Oakdale wasn't very far from Angels camp, so she probably had 20 of her friends around there. Boy, they all fired up and come watch us stick it on some rank bulls. And Wasey had Danny Boy, which was a very ranked bull. He was featured at the NFR and ranked men several times. And so my mom's got all of her friends and her family there. They're just, you know, can't wait for us to ride. Well, at Redding, we don't go to bed. We stay up all night long. And we get to Angels Camp just a little bit, you know, a little bit before the rodeo, and we're not feeling too good. And everybody's excited. They don't know how bad we feel, or how we feel right now. And We all get on our bulls, and all three of our rides, now this is Wasey, Charlie, and myself, all three of our rides didn't add up to 8 seconds. My mom said, I'm not ever telling anybody to come watch you guys ride again. It was funny because it just didn't work out. But you know what? I don't feel like we're just friends right here. I feel like we're family. I've known a lot of people in here for a long time. I'm just saying that it's family and friends is what's going to matter when we take our last breath. I hope you guys have a great afternoon.
World champion Ted Nuce, man, he's a world champion father. I've been following his kids on Facebook. He's teaching them how to work, how to ride. I mean, it's pretty awesome to watch this all happen.